Welcome to Talk Law Radio with attorney Todd Marquardt of the Marquardt Law Firm at MarquardtLawFirm.com.
Welcome back to Talk Law Radio. I'm Todd Marquardt on 9:30 a.m. The Answer. Podcasts everywhere, Facebook Live and YouTube. Remember to subscribe to our YouTube channel. That's where you can listen to this 48-minute episode in bite-sized chunks. We break that down into 10-minute segments so that you can enjoy throughout the week. We also have shorter videos that are around 30 seconds or so. You can find those on YouTube. Just search for Talk Law Radio on YouTube and look for Lady Justice and the red, white, and blue logo. And click the subscribe button. It would really help me out if you would click subscribe, because YouTube has these rules that don't allow me to stream live until I have 1,000 subscribers. And I know that I have 1,000 listeners, many thousands of listeners, so there's probably at least 1,000 of you that enjoy listening to me talk about the law on the radio enough for you to click subscribe on YouTube. And if you click the little bell, you'll get an alert on your computer or smartphone to let you know when new episodes are being uploaded. That really helped me out. That'd be a nice Christmas gift for me to wake up on Christmas morning and see that my YouTube channel has 1,000 subscribers. If I was going to write a letter to Santa, that's what I would ask him to do, to have all his little elves subscribing to Talk Law Radio. Wouldn't that be funny? Today I'm talking about the Corporate Transparency Act. If you're just joining us, this is an act that requires businesses that are filed, like LLCs, corporations, partnerships. Limited partnership is an entity that does file with a Secretary of State. If you're an informal partnership, you don't really have to file. If you run a business as a sole proprietor, you don't have anything filed. But for those of us who want to protect ourselves from liability or limit our liability, those types of entities do file, and those are the ones that are generally required to register with FinCEN. And I've been talking about FinCEN. FinCEN is the United States Department of Treasury Financial Crimes Enforcement Network. And how do you feel about registering your law-abiding business with a financial crimes enforcement network? It's like, do I have to register myself as a law-abiding individual with the FBI? Do I have to submit my fingerprints just for the privilege of being a United States citizen? It seems to me that this is the road that we're going down. During one of the Republican debates, it was discussed that presidential candidate Nikki Haley wants everyone using social media to have to verify their identity to prove that we're not robots, because she wants to cut down on bots in the social media arena to prevent, you know, other foreign adversaries from using social media as a psychological tool against us. How do you feel about registering yourself or your business to prevent crime? Call me at 210-308-8867 right now and tell me how you feel about that. Does that make you think that you're losing a little bit of liberty and freedom when you have to register things with the federal government? Or is this something you think is needed to prevent from bad people from tax evasion, drug trafficking, sex trafficking, money laundering, and financial terrorism? I just remembered We're supposed to talk about saints and sinners. Love that song. I'm a sinner, I'm a saint. But Martin Luther would say, I'm forgiven and absolved because of what Jesus did for us by dying on the cross and rising to new life 3 days later. But it all began on Christmas 2,000 years ago. Jesus was born in a manger, and I encourage you to go to a Christmas service somewhere in town and be reminded of the Christmas story. So today's saint is going to be Justice Sandra Day O'Connor. She passed away recently, and I just want to recognize her for her service to the federal United States Supreme Court. She was the first woman justice. She was appointed by President Ronald Reagan in 1981. She served until 2006. And in 2009, President Barack Obama awarded her with the nation's highest civilian honor, the Presidential Medal of Freedom. And here's a fun fact. I met Justice O'Connor personally when I was studying international law at the University of Innsbruck in Austria. And so that's a fun fact. She's our saint because she served our country and helped interpret laws, and we honor her for that. The sinner is Hunter Biden because he was indicted for felony tax offenses and misdemeanor tax offenses. And you probably already heard about that in the news, but just in case you didn't, the indictment says that for 4 years he didn't pay $1.4 million in federal taxes, and it says he evaded taxes for the year 2018 and filed false returns. You might remember that there's another famous person that went to prison for tax evasion, Al Capone. So maybe Hunter Biden is our modern day Al Capone. If convicted, he faces a maximum penalty of 17 years in prison. You may have also heard that he was in the Senate recently giving a public statement about how unfair it is that he's being indicted. He didn't go over to the House because he was subpoenaed to give deposition testimony over there. And just an interesting fact that if you're on the Senate side of things, just present over there, the House of Representatives cannot require you to come over to the House side. That's just a weird coincidence. If you want to read the actual indictment, let me know. I'll email it to you. Email me at host@talklawradio.com, host@talklawradio.com, and I'll email you a copy of this indictment. So back to the Corporate Transparency Act. It's estimated that in 2024 alone, there's expected to be 33 million entities filing with FinCEN. And FinCEN is the federal U.S. Department of Treasury's Financial Crimes Enforcement Network. That's who you have to file with, unless there's an exception. And big businesses are exempt because the theory is that they already are regulated under other statutes. So if you're a bank or you're a financial services company like a brokerage or stock company, you already have to file with other federal agencies, and they already monitor what you're doing. If your LLC or corporation or limited partnership has gross revenues less than, no, excuse me, if you earn more, if your revenue is more than $5 million annually, if that's what it says on your tax return, and you have more than 20 employees, and then you're probably going to be exempt. So this is one of the regulations that actually targets small businesses. So those that earn less than $5 million and those that have a small number of employees, which is a lot of businesses, because the economy in the United States is built on small businesses. And so mom and pop shops everywhere will be looking for help in complying with the Corporate Transparency Act. And you're probably wondering, what happens if I don't report? What happens if I don't register with the Financial Crimes Enforcement Network? Well, I'll tell you. And after this break, you'll want to know, because you don't want to have to pay these fines and you don't want to have to go to jail. Stay tuned.
This has been Talk Law Radio with attorney Todd Marquardt, brought to you by the Marquardt Law Firm. You can learn more at marquardtlawfirm.com. And be sure to listen to the full Talk Law Radio show Saturday mornings at 11 on 9:30 a.m. The Answer. Each week, attorney Todd Marquardt talks about the law. His mission with the Talk Law Radio show and podcast is to help you discover your legal issue blind spots. In the beginning, God had one law: don't eat from the fruit of that tree. Then came the Ten Commandments. Now we have federal, state, and municipal lawmakers that won't stop creating new laws, laws that might impact you without you knowing it. Listen to the show and drop a line on Facebook or email host@talklawradio.com and let the host know what you think of the show, the topics you want to hear, and whether you want to be a guest.